3440 pixels by 1440 pixels contained within 34 inches. Sometimes you go a lot lower, sometimes you want to go higher. A lot higher. The monitor is the core component of your workspace and the core component of your PC build. Everything centers around the monitor. It determines the size of your table, the monitor arm you use, the GPU you buy. Everything you do on the computer, you do it through the monitor. You may not always be typing on the keyboard or moving the mouse, but if you're at your computer, you're probably looking at the screen. So the question is, how big a screen? How much content do you want displayed? I ordered this HP Z40c because it was on sale, but it came defective. In fact, completely unusable.
How many 48 hours do you think HP is gonna ask me to wait before I can get a proper response?
Hello? Yeah, that's me. Ah, okay. So basically, there is no more stock in Singapore, and you don't have any estimated date of when the next shipment would arrive. So refund is the only option at the moment. Ah, okay, sure. Yeah. Okay, so basically I'll get a full refund and you'll have a courier come over to pick this up. Yep, that's fine. Okay, sure. Nah, no problem. Thank you very much. Thank you, bye. A 13.3-inch display is probably enough when you're on the road or at a cafe, but at home, you definitely want something larger. But maybe not 43-inch large. That's better for movies at a distance. How about 27-inch or 32 inches? What about aspect ratios? A 16:9 aspect ratio 27-inch display, when you stretch that a bit, you get a 34-inch 21:9 ultra-wide display. Put two of these 27-inch displays together, and you get a 49-inch. A 16:9 aspect ratio 32-inch display is great too, even better when you get one at 4K resolution. And then you stretch this one a bit, and you'll get
Thank you.
This is the Lenovo P40w-20. It is a 39.7-inch, 21:9 aspect ratio, ultrawide monitor, running at 5K/2K resolution. That is a whopping 5120x2160 pixels. And it comes with a whole host of features to complement it. The 100mm by 100mm VESA mount on this monitor means that I can use back my existing wall mount.
Finally got it wall mounted. But somehow it looks very plain. I think there's something missing.
A Thunderbolt 4 display allows you to quickly hook up a laptop. With up to 100 watts of power delivery, it can handle even the highest-end MacBook Pros with ease. But it doesn't just do Thunderbolt and power. It also comes with a full-fledged hub of USB ports and even a network port. DisplayPort 1.4 lets me hook this up to my PC and run it at full resolution too. Out of the box, it supports 75Hz refresh rate. But testing that in a real-world scenario shows that 75Hz is an overclocked rate. The panel is still a 60Hz native panel, and games run a lot more smoothly at that refresh rate. I had 100Hz with my 34-inch Prism monitor, and I tried 144Hz on the Asus 43-inch previously as well. But honestly, I don't need 144Hz or even 100Hz. I don't think I'll make any good use of it at all. Plus, majority of my time on this monitor is spent on work, not games. This is a 5K/2K screen. If you're a gamer, you have to remember that all of those pixels need to be driven by your GPU. And if you're not running anything other than the highest tier cards, then your GPU probably isn't going to cut it. If you're expecting to play AAA titles like Cyberpunk or Dying Light at 5K/2K, even if it is only 60Hz. At Ray Tracing Ultra, I was barely getting 50 frames per second in Cyberpunk, and I'm running an RTX 3080. It's hard to really illustrate to you how much screen estate is available at this resolution. Let's compare an Excel spreadsheet.
This one's so much lighter. Okay, on the old 1440p ultrawide, I'm getting about 53 columns at 100% Excel zoom. And on the new one, I'm getting 79 columns, 79.
The 2500R curvature on this versus the 1500R on my previous display is actually quite subtle. There's no visible backlight bleed as well. Unfortunately, this second Thunderbolt port is for daisy chaining other Thunderbolt devices and not for a second computer. You can, however, use a USB upstream to hook up the second computer. There is a built-in KVM. Press this button and all the USB devices will switch between the Thunderbolt device and whatever's hooked up to the USB upstream. For the network port, however, this monitor actually acts as a network switch and provides connectivity to both devices simultaneously. Pretty awesome. As with most ultrawides, Lenovo also has a PBP picture-by-picture feature. One of my favorite use cases for PBP is really with two computers, and one computer has to go on an office VPN to test certain servers or certain ongoing developments, while the other computer can continue to maintain my Zoom calls, my Skype calls, so it's easy to continue the communication without having it break just because you have to connect and disconnect the VPN over and over again. Lenovo also has a feature called TrueSplit that allows your device to recognize this monitor as two separate displays over that single DisplayPort or Thunderbolt cable. I guess this might be useful in scenarios where you have to share your full desktop over a Zoom call. And at 5K 2K resolution, there's no way you can share that.
This report was basically in the box. It came with the monitor. Basically, it says that Lenovo factory calibrated every single panel that they ship out, and it has a pre-tuned standard mode, sRGB 6500K, with an average delta E of less than 2.0. Honestly, I'm not a professional, so I have no idea what this means, but just using the panel on a day-to-day basis, I really like the colors on it.
You definitely want a window management utility with a monitor like this. I use Fancy Zones that comes with Windows 10 Power Toys, and on macOS, I'm currently using a tool called Moom.
The main problems with the 39.7-inch display is really about price and availability. There are only 4 brands on the market right now that I know carry this size, which would be LG, Dell, HP, and Lenovo. So for the LG, right, it actually supports FreeSync out of the box, so to me that was one of the best options. Unfortunately, it's completely unavailable in Singapore, and if you try to ship it in from like US or Hong Kong, it costs a ton because the monitor is so heavy. For the Dell, I didn't look at the Dell at all because it was the most pricey. It was actually 2,500 Singapore dollars, maybe a little bit higher, and it was also the only display that supported up to Thunderbolt 3 instead of up to Thunderbolt 4. The HP was actually my first option because I thought it was the most interesting. It even had a built-in pop-up webcam, which I thought provided a lot of additional functionality and a lot of value. But I mean, you know what happened to the HP, and that's kind of how I ended up with this Lenovo. And honestly, because all of them are actually the same LG IPS panel, in terms of the quality of the panel, it doesn't really differentiate that much. So you're really looking around the other feature sets, around warranty and support, etc. And I mean, with the story about the HP one, I'm kind of glad that I ended up with the Lenovo instead right now. If you're fully productivity focused, then actually at this price point, you might be better off with two 32-inch 4K displays instead, which might work better for your workflow, whether you are, I don't know, a UX or graphic designer or a programmer or coder. So for me personally, I really like the 21:9 aspect ratio. I've been using it since basically late 2015. And that jump from 1440p to 2160p was exactly what I was looking for in an endgame display. So that's why I'm that niche audience that this monitor actually caters to. And if you are a hardcore gamer, you probably don't want to be using a 5K 2K display because your GPU has to run all of these pixels. And even for me, using an RTX 3080, it's still a little bit of a struggle in games like Cyberpunk and some of the other AAA titles. So honestly, if you're a hardcore gamer, I'd rather you look at 1440p displays where you can easily push up to like 144Hz or 165Hz refresh rate, which would be a lot more comfortable for whether it's casual gameplay or even competitive gameplay. For me, I play a lot of MMOs mostly, so 60Hz really suits me fine. And I don't really use the high refresh rate anyway. I think the key takeaway is that the monitor is probably the most important component of any computer setup. All the information that you take in, all the things that you do on a computer, all the videos you watch, etc., everything is through this screen. And of all the parts that you upgrade in your computer, I mean, you might change the RAM, the SSD, the CPU, the graphics card, etc., even the computer case. Of all the parts that we change the most often, actually the monitor tends to be the one that we change the least. I've known people who have been using the same monitor for basically the last 5 to 10 years. So if you're buying a monitor, I think you should buy one that you're prepared to use for the next 3 to 5 years. For me, the Lenovo 39.7-inch ultra-wide 5K 2K display is the one that I really want to be using for the next 3 to 5 years. Anyway, that's all for today's video. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.